Hey guys, I'm Sabirul Islam and welcome to another episode of Build Your Confidence on Stage. Now, before I get into the heart of today's episode, if you haven't subscribed yet, I'd love you to do so by clicking on the subscribe button below. And don't forget to click on the bell notification icon to stay tuned to each and every episode that I launch every week. Now, in today's episode, I cover a topic which is very crucial in the world of public speaking. Now, you don't want to be a presenter on stage and not be able to grab any attention. So in today's episode, we cover the topic of grabbing audience attention. Now, I'm sure you've been to an event or two where you've actually seen the speaker go through some hard times because the audience are just fiddling around with their phone or just gossiping with one another, whereas the speaker himself or herself are actually talking about something very important. You're tuned in, but everyone else around is pretty much not really paying attention. So as the speaker, that's quite a daunting experience to face because you don't want to be that person where you're speaking and telling something so important and meaningful to you where it actually means nothing to the audience itself. So how can you grab attention? Well, in this episode, we'll be covering three very important topics. Number one is about the unexpected. Secondly, we'll be covering what's called the big question. And thirdly, it's all about the performance act. So what to expect from the unexpected when it comes to grabbing audience attention? Now, I want to tell you a very quick story. I was in Botswana around 8-9 years ago, and it was a very profound event in one of the sessions that I attended. And a lot of speakers spoke, very short time, and it was all to do with change, making some form of impact and change in their communities. And there was one young lady who came on stage, and she was there on the stage for the first 30 seconds or so, she didn't say anything. It was just a flickering of images in the background. Hundreds of images in quick succession, and all of a sudden, boom, one standout image that completely shook me to the core, shook the entire audience to the core. And that image had a young child with a vulture in the background. Now, this young child was almost starving, was pretty much starving, and there was a vulture in the background. I've never seen this image before, and it completely shook me to the core. But one thing it did do is grab my attention as to, yes, I need to listen to this lady speak because she has something important to say. So why would she put it on hundreds of happy-dappy images and all of a sudden, boom, one image that completely shakes the entire audience? But what she did smart was grab the audience attention. And that's when she began her speech and telling the story. So why am I telling you this? Because when it comes to grabbing audience attention with the unexpected, the utilizing of your senses. How can you do it visually? How can you do it through touch? How can you do it through even taste, smell, all of these things that your senses are able to utilize? Now, many people do it through objects. They come on stage, they have an object at hand, whether it's a chair, whether it's a pillow, everything, but you have to realize that it has to represent your speech. It has to represent you. So my message here is, my point here is that if you want to do the unexpected or create an unexpected, utilize the senses in which you have your speech at hand, you've prepared your speech, you know what you're sharing, you know how you're going to do it, but you want to utilize this object or you want to utilize a certain sound in the background, a noise in the background that grabs audience attention. Now, another example I can give when it comes to sound is I was attending a theater performance. The curtains were drawn. Me and my wife at that time, we were just gossiping away, talking. The presentation wasn't even about to start. And all of a sudden, boom, loud noise. And that obviously grabs audience attention. It's not relevant for every presentation, especially if you're in a corporate environment delivering a presentation to a few clients, but you have to adjust. How can you grab the attention based on the situation, based on the scenario, based on the environment? So I would try and utilize senses in the best possible manner to grab audience attention. So that would be my first advice when it comes to grabbing audience attention, because it's one of the core ways in which you're able to instantly make impact without even having to say a word. Secondly, when it comes to grabbing audience attention, what I would do definitely is ask the question. Now, what do I mean by the question? Well, every time I go on stage, depending on the stage setting, the scenario, the situation, whoever the audience is, and obviously what the conference is all about, if the question is relevant, I will throw it right at the offset. So what I would do is I would go on stage. As I'm walking on the stage, I will just, my question always will be that philosophical question. When you leave this world, What will you be remembered for? And there's a moment of pause. And that pause, that moment of pause there is what grabs that attention. And then you hear utter silence. People don't talk. People are tuned in. Why on earth has he asked me this question? And then they start thinking. Psychologically, internally, they're thinking, they're asking themselves this question, when you leave this world, what will you be remembered for? And then they're trying to answer that. And a lot of people find it very difficult, very challenging. So I would encourage, whenever you're going on stage, you want to grab the audience's attention, ask them a very philosophical question, but make sure it links with your message. And how you link it with your message is you need to have a story. So if you want to capture audience attention or grab audience attention, make sure you have a story to tell. That story can be deep-rooted, it can be personal, and it has to have some form of meaning for you in order for you to express that emotions and share that emotions with the audience. So I would buy into the concept of having a big, bold question which you can ask right from the offset. And even for those who don't want to ask the question from the beginning, in the middle of the presentation itself, halfway through your speech, you can throw in a question there, but make sure there's that emotionally, it's emotionally connected, and there's that element of pause there. If you leave that, if you don't let it land with the pause, then you've instantly lost the audience and they don't take it as seriously. So that's important. The big question is vital to grab audience attention, connected with the story and also the element of the pause. One of the unique ways in which you can grab audience attention is through what's called the performance act. Almost like performing a mini act before you come or when you're coming on stage. Now, I want to give you a quick example. I was at an event a few years ago and it was on the subject of climate change. So I was one of the attendees that time listening in. And there was a young lady who comes on stage. She has a really big bag on her side, and as she was stepping up onto the stage, every step she took, she was throwing out an object, and every object she threw out, there were statistics playing in the background on a presentation slide, and she didn't say a word for about a good couple of minutes, and all she was doing was throwing objects. These were plastic bottles, she was tearing up pieces of paper, there was matchsticks that she flamed up, and everything she was doing had statistics that really resonated with the audience because it was telling us a story of how it impacts us on our day-to-day lives. So we connected with her instantly just from what she was doing without her even having to say a word. So I want you to take that concept that how can you go on stage and perform an act either before you start speaking or during your presentation and actually leverage on an act that you can do. Now, acts can be anything. You can play dual characters. You can be two person playing, one individual playing two different roles, or you can actually perform on stage, whether it's a singer, a dance or whatever. I'm not a big singer, but that's what I did. When I was invited to go on stage in Nepal, I had a very personal connection in Nepal when I went over there, and one of my teachers who during my childhood in my primary school days, she was also from there as well, and she taught me how to sing and as well. So one of the best things I learned about that when I went to Nepal is that personal connection with my childhood and singing and the country itself. So as I was telling my story and so forth, halfway through my presentation, I started singing. I didn't have to think about it. I just started singing and the audience were glued in and they started singing with me because it made sense. It was relevant because the personality and the people that I knew there and then at that point in time in Nepal, they connected with them. So it was really, really well thought out to be able to perform an act that was relevant to the audience because I had that connection. So it's important that you know the audience and you know the people around you, and when you're performing an act that actually makes sense. But it's a great way to grab an attention. So I would say play around with it, rehearse it, script write it, do something that grabs an audience attention that is enabled you to be unique, be remembered. It won't work for every situation, every scenario. What you don't want to do is go to a corporate setting, you're pitching to a client and you start singing. That doesn't work. So what you want to do is know the actual setting, environment, scenario, who the people are, who the audience are. Again, it's to do with that triangle formula I spoke about in a previous episode. You as the speaker, know your audience, know your subject. So it's important that all of that is tuned in. So once you have that at hand, when you perform a mini act on stage that is unexpected, ideally before you come on stage, then you've got them hooked. Then you've got the audience hooked and they want to listen to you. And ultimately, when you have them hooked, you tell your story. Once you finish your speech, you'll be remembered. Whether it's a point or two that you made or a really big core aspect of your presentation, they take away and they learn something, or they become transformed individual because of what you said. They remember you. And ultimately, you as the speaker, that's what you want. So in today's episode, we covered three very important things on how you're able to grab audience attention. Number one was about the unexpected, utilizing the audience senses. So every aspect of what you do has to touch an element of their sense to be able to hook them in. Number two was the question. So coming up on stage and asking a very thought-provoking, very philosophical question that gets them hooked into your presentation, and then landing with the pause. The moment you land with that pause, you have them interested and they want to hear more. And thirdly was the performance act. Now, the performance act requires a lot of confidence, a lot of courage, as does public speaking in general. But I would say practice it. Give as much time and effort in trying to figure out what works and what doesn't based on the situation, scenario, and the audience you're presenting to. And so that you have all of these key things in place to be able to grab audience attention. Everything you do on stage requires confidence, performance, and more importantly, self-acceptance. And once you have that in the bag, you're good to go. So I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Build Your Confidence on Stage. Stay tuned to next week's episode where I'll be covering various other topics. But if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe and remember to click on the bell notification icon. And I look forward to seeing you all next week. Thanks guys for watching this episode. Now, if you're serious about kickstarting your career in public speaking, I'm launching the Build Your Confidence on Stage book and online modular public speaking course, where I will teach you the four pillars of public speaking, which include the speaker psychology, the principles of public speaking, the performance masterclass, and the profession of a public speaker. So if you're keen on harnessing your public speaking skills and turning your passion for speaking into a lifestyle profession, then register your interest now by visiting www.buildyourconfidenceonstage.com. The link is below, and I look forward to supporting your public speaking learning journey. See you next week.